Hello, my name is Mohammed Sabo Kiara and I'm from Nigeria. I advocate for social inclusion of vulnerable children called Almajiri in northern part of the country. According to the UNICEF, there are 10.5 million out of school children in Nigeria. 9 million of these children are in the northern part of the country in form of Almajiri children. The Almajiri are children sent into a cultural and religious education system that precludes them from access to basic formal education. Besides the fact that they are out of school, they face several challenges, nutritional challenges aggravated by daily street begging. Many live in some of the shabbiest conditions imaginable. Many are exposed to abuse and exploitation that no child should be exposed to. Over the years, successive governments in our country have turned a blind eye to the plight of these children. There have not been enough action and enough policy to address this issue in our country, and it's one of the most pressing issues in northern Nigeria today. Prioritizing investment and in the education and welfare of these children could increase the per capita income that will lift millions of children out of poverty and that will help in and achieving the sustainable development goal and ensuring peace and stability in our country. Our organization have been working to increase the and amplify the plight of these children. We have been working and using our platform as a vehicle that mobilizes resources, energy, that will push for the policy change that will ensure the social inclusion of these children. Over the last few years, we have enlisted the support and partnership of various stakeholders across the country, both local and international, like the ECOWAS Commission, the Open Society for West Africa Initiative, the National Assembly, to initiate and pressure the government in and amending policies that will lead to the social inclusion of these children. Last year, we institutionalized and launched a new day called the Almajiri Child Rights Day, which is focused at bringing the national and global attention to the indignity these children face. And we're able to get the office of the Deputy Secretary General and the Danish Ambassador to Nigeria to get involved in this and organize this day. But most specifically in our achievement is the proposed National Child Restitution Bill that is being sponsored for the first time in the Nigerian Parliament. And our organization were invited to make a contribution to this important bill that is focused and aims specifically to address the issue of child restitution involving these millions of these children.
Through our advocacy, we have been able to attract educational support to tens of these children across some locations in northern Nigeria. We are able to also attract both food and non-food items. We are able to improve their living and shelter condition. Addressing the plight of the Almajiri children is very critical to attaining the sustainable development goal in Nigeria, because these children are faced with the issue of lack of education. They are faced with the issue of lack of health and sanitation. They are faced with the issue of poverty. They are faced with the issue of hunger. The achievements that we secured last year in form of the Child Restitution Commission Bill is very, very important and strategic for us in this advocacy. And an opportunity with the Obama Scholarship Program will avail us the opportunity to improve on our skills, to deepen our leadership skill and capacity. It will go a long way to impact the work we do that is aimed at empowering vulnerable children, saving millions of children who are put into the condition they are today. An opportunity to get this scholarship, to be part of this scholarship program this year, will go a long way to equip me and my team with the necessary and requisite leadership skills that will help us to achieving the goal of a policy change that will affect millions of children in northern Nigeria. And this, whatever we are able to achieve, could be replicated to affect other children who are under the same practice and system in other West African countries.